Welcome to Bear's Kitchen.
I was born and raised in the South, in a city, and now I live in the Midwest on a farm, and I love it. Other things I love are Jesus, my family, and everything food. I'm so glad you decided to join me today.
We're in Bear's Kitchen. I'm so excited, my sweet brother, for how many years now, Phil?
Oh, it's over like 42.
Because you started dating Shanny, my sweet sister, honey, when?
Our first date was on my 16th birthday because we could drive. We went to the fair. And so you were eight, I think, or something like that.
The point is, you've always felt like a real brother to me. Not brother in love, but real brother. And I mean, even through, you know, the selling of candy bars for different fundraisers through school, because you're really good at sales.
That's right.
But you're also a movie producer. I just have to say that. And you owned your own company.
Yes.
And you're semi-retired, but...
That's right. But one of my favorite things is to cook, so...
I have to just add that your idea of retirement is not what we normally would think. Because you're still busy every day with your grandbabies and your business ventures.
And cooking shows.
Okay, so Phil, what are we going to make in your kitchen today?
This used to be called Phil's French Toast, but I've changed it to Bear's French Toast. Now that I've graduated to being a grandfather, so that's my grandfather name. But this is kind of my version of French Toast. And so what I thought I'd do, Marci, is I thought I'd kind of take you through the ingredients.
I would love that!
Because my French Toast is a little bit different than probably what you're used to. And I'm going to start right here. This is a Texas toast. Most times when you get French toast from a restaurant or French toast that you're familiar with, it's on a thick piece of bread, thick French toast. French toast, believe it or not, you probably don't know this.
I probably
don't. Was not invented in France. It was actually invented by Joseph French in 1724, and it was in Massachusetts. So
that
to me explains why most people have to put so much sugar and syrup on it. If, you know, other than lobster, not much good comes from Massachusetts. No offense, Massachusetts. I feel like most people go kind of down the wrong trail of bread too thick. This is a good bread.
All right. I'm so glad Madeline is here.
So we're not going to use that today. And I have experimented with a lot of breads.
Okay? Oh, you have?
Yes, I've tried to make good-for-you bread tastes good, and just hadn't worked for me yet, and you know, that's maybe another show for somebody else. So you can't go wrong with, I'm not going to say the brand name, but you just can't go wrong here. I used to go to the church. It was across the street from the Wonder Bread Factory.
So
my dad knew a dad on the line, and we would stop after church, and he would run in and come out with fresh Wonder Bread.
Oh.
And they don't quite finish cooking it when it goes in the bag.
You're kidding me. You're kidding me.
So it's this doughy, awesome thing that we would have killed on the way home. So.
Yum!
Yeah, that's a good choice.
I love that story!
And all my world search for the proper bread. Okay, and this is what I've come up with as the best. And here's the thing. The characteristics are it's not too thick. It's thin. It absorbs the egg. So I like mine very eggy. And so that's what we're going to use here today.
This is so big. Yes. You can feed a giant family on this. Okay. Ours is very big.
But that's one of the points. This recipe is really made for you. You've got company over. You just want something good to eat that's easy to eat. This is really a finger food. And so you go through these layers.
That's amazing.
Safe and easy. In fact, that's kind of part of the history on my recipe. My recipe goes back to the Roman Empire. The Rome was kind of the first to use bread and eggs together and cook. It was because it was cheap and easy to feed the legionnaires in the field.
Oh my goodness.
And they could get locals to contribute bread and eggs better than they wanted to contribute their animals or whatever. So it just kind of worked out for them where they could get their protein. And so that's kind of cool.
Isn't that cool? I love history.
So then I've got the eggs. I always pick jumbo eggs. The bigger the better on the eggs. And I've used 6 today. Egg preferences. I'm a little suspicious with free range. And I'll tell you why. Well, Marci, you have free range chickens, right?
Well, one chicken now. But yeah, who's counting?
And good point. Because where do they lay? Where do free range chickens lay their eggs?
Anywhere if they want.
Anywhere. So when somebody says they were a free range chicken, I'm like, well, they're not chasing those things around all day. We got one smart chicken on the farm right now. Oh, also, if you've ever been in the chicken yard, but I have.
A chicken yard?
Yeah, a chicken yard, a bunch of chickens. You know, free ranging around. I personally want the antibiotics in my chicken. That's a nasty place. So, I'm just saying, you know, those of you that have never been out of New York, you know, antibiotics might be better than you think. So, that's just, you know, no judgment. Here are the critical components. Ooh. I've got milk here, and I use 2%. And it
2%?
Just
not splits
the difference. Splits the difference. I don't know that it makes any difference.
Okay.
The milk thins it out a little bit, and it's still flavorful. Yeah. And this has been a component from the very beginning. I didn't really know that until I researched for this.
So. Oh, I love that.
And the thing that I like, too, is I like the pepper.
Fresh ground.
And I like the fresh ground. But you cannot go overboard. You'll be crunching these things. It'll just take away. I've got an open milk that I'm just going to go ahead here and pour right in. And
how much are you pouring in, Phil?
Some.
Okay.
You know,
that's a scientific measurement.
If you want it thinner, put more milk. If you like it thicker, don't put any milk at all.
And you're just whipping it up with a fork.
I am just whipping it up with a fork.
Okay, so you don't use a whisk.
I don't use a whisk. This bowl is 39 years old. This is one of our wedding sets. Oh. After four kids, and now eight grandkids. About the only thing left from the original set.
That's so great.
So these are our everyday dishes.
It's so big. Yeah. Like, was that a cereal bowl?
I'm not sure. It's always been a French toast bowl.
French toast bowl. There's French toast. There you go.
That's exactly right. And last, got butter and brands. I like Great Value, and also in the Midwest, that Best is really good.
Yes.
And you get more for your money. And
there you go.
We like it salted. I mean, salted.
We too.
This makes it better.
So, amen. Glory.
And the key in this recipe is you don't want to short yourself on butter or eggs. This is an eggy, buttery type. dish. So. Okay. So I get kind of a thick little pad, and I put it in. So while that's melting, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to open the bread.
What's your favorite
bread? For French toast.
For French toast. Yes. Okay. So I love how you have different tools.
Absolutely.
For different
right bread for the right occasion.
Oh,
that's
there's
right.
a sermon in there somewhere.
That's exactly right. So I'm going to pull out four here. And see, this is just thin white bread. So it absorbs really well.
Okay.
What I've done here is just the butter is barely melted. And I'll go in, and so I've started with a cold pan. I didn't start the heat until the butter was in there. So I want the butter just melted. I don't want it burned. And so all I'm really doing in here is soaking. I'm just letting this stuff soak up.
Okay.
If you let it sit, it'll soak up too much and be soggy.
Good point.
But if you just kind of go through and dunk it here, you just give it a good dunk.
A good quick dunk back and forth. Okay.
Good quick dunk.
Love that.
And so I'm going to do that here and going to get that started right in there. What I've done here, Marci, is I'm using a big pan.
Okay.
It's a medium heat. I've got gas. I don't want it to be too hot.
Okay.
Because what I don't want to do is burn it. And in fact, it's a little bit labor intensive. Ooh. I'm going to sit here and even start turning it even before it seems ready.
Okay.
I will start turning it because I want to get it all kind of, the middle's going to be hotter with gas.
Okay.
We'll rotate it around, trying to cook every edge. We want it cooked enough to be cooked because it's eggs.
Yes.
But we don't want to overcook it, or all you'll taste is kind of the burnt egg part.
So, good point.
Yeah.
I've never thought of putting pepper in my French toast, but I'm so excited.
Yes.
That's like a little secret ingredient almost.
It is.
You wouldn't think a little savory in there?
That's right. And the
fresh
pepper is so good.
Fresh pepper. Yes.
Yes. All right. What we're going to do is we're going to put it on a plate. This is my son Pug made this for me in 1996. He is a pediatric dentist now, so this has been around a while.
Yes.
But it's a great
plate. I love
this plate
so much.
Yes, it is just a great plate. I love it.
It's so happy.
Thank you, Pug.
It's so Pug. Pediatric dentistry fits him.
That's right. So we're gonna keep working this.
Speaking of Pug, this is Miss Audrey Pug's youngest daughter.
She's
brushing her teeth. She's brushing her teeth. We didn't stage this. Say hi, camera.
You show good, babe.
All right. While we're cooking here, did you want to talk about these wonderful flowers?
Yes, talk about the flowers Bear got you.
He had ordered me flowers for nothing. Actually, it was because I'd done our taxes the day before, and I hate just getting them prepared to go to the accountant. And this is Shannon. I appreciate you. Love you. Okay, this is, I knew
it was a pushy card.
Because when I was at Marci's last week for my birthday, a big arrangement of flowers came, and it was from Phil. And the card says, honey, all my love, with all my heart, forever and ever, love Bear. And I was like, Bear? Thanks for the flowers, but did you write that card? And he's like, well, Marci knew my sentiment. And I told Marci, I said, women should always order things for the other person. But this is Phil. Shit,
I appreciate you. Love Phil.
And I knew Phil's heart toward
That's
you.
That's right.
And he said no budget, so.
So this teaches us that the executive assistant ordering birthday presents is underrated.
Shani, we talked about your bowl that's the French toast bowl that was part of your wedding china. Part of your everyday china for
I am so proud you remember that. Yep. That's the only thing left.
That's 39 years ago. The marriage is left.
Yes.
Y'all are a great team. These two have been such an example to all of us our whole lives. It's amazing.
Love Jesus and love each other.
There you go. Preach it.
That's right.
Oh, it's so sweet. Oh,
see ya.
Bye, y'all. I'm about to take this off. These are a little bit overdone. A little bit, but it's not a disaster.
It smells so good. They smell so good. And
here's what I did. I put them on here.
Okay.
And then I just go ahead and slice them right down the middle of the spatula.
Just slice them right away.
And these, Marci, you don't, it, if it's too hot, it's too hot. But the hotter, the better.
Okay, well, let's do it then. That is so hot, but... I mean,
you eat it like finger food, and you can eat it with bacon if you want it to be a little bit deeper, I suppose.
But, this is so hot, but it is so good.
And you can let it cool off there. But I always think the hotter the better. And so what we'll do is get a plate like this and just start stacking. And then when I put the next batch in, I will move these to the top so the heat rises from the ones on the bottom to keep the top of the top. And people just come by, you know, you can tell the atmosphere. People just run around, grab a French toast. And just start snacking. And so it's a great way to feed a lot of people.
It's a great way. And they're so good. Yeah. This is still burning hot, but so good. And it doesn't even have syrup.
That's right.
I love it.
You can put syrup, but I almost feel like it's also a good steak. I like them just plain tang. So.
Amen.
But you can put syrup on it. And that's the way you'll find most recipes, is they come up with different ways to pile on the sugar.
And this tastes so good on its own.
It does.
It's just great on its own.
So too. That's right. My family was raised on this, so they love it this way. If you've been raised on syrup, it might seem plain. So that's, you know, put syrup on it if that's what you like. So,
well, yeah. I was raised on syrup, but that is so good.
It is good, isn't it?
You opened my eyes. All right. This is amazing.
That's right. Okay. One more thing, everybody. Last trick what I'm doing is I'm cooling off this pan because it'll get too hot. I got to cool it off every time I make any batch.
Ooh, in between.
So, that's right. So I would throw butter on that and then kind of redo, but cool it down in between.
That is a great tip. We always dance on the show, you know.
Okay,
so.
That's good because, Marci, another thing you may not have known about me.
Oh, okay.
Before I met your sister, just a few months before your sister.
Yes.
Ninth grade. Dance off champion of Mabelville Junior High.
Wait, are you serious?
That's right. That's exactly right.
So, you went to Mabelville before you went to Plaski.
That's exactly right.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Phil, maybe you could show me a moves from that time period in your life.
We probably shouldn't do that because basically in the 70s, the big move was to be able to go down into the splits so that I can't do it anymore. And then come right back up. Come right back up. You got to come back up. I can't do it anymore. But I did. That was my signature move.
You literally went down to the splits and
came
back
up. That's right. You got to do it all. Gotta
That's
have,
amazing.
You
got
to have slick shoes and those powered away razors. Well, here's what happened. I blew the rear out of my pants. So we're in the middle of a dance at Pleasant Valley Country Club, which is a pretty cool place around here. And so I had to go over to her mama's house, hand her my pants, and she mended it up, got me suited up, and we were back at the dance.
I'm always finding out something new.
And anybody that knows her mama knows she would absolutely just take my pants and sew them up. And send me back.
She would.
Yeah.
She's great like that.
She didn't miss a beat.
Thank you, Mom. It's like I will sew the pants. Back in the pants.
Yeah. Well, Marci, since I'm from the 70s,
okay.
Can we do the bump?
Let's do the bump.
All right.
Okay,
we'll do the bump. Then we'll even practice here.
Is it
bump? Double. That's a double bump. Double bump. Double bump. Double bump.
So much for letting us cook in your kitchen, brother. I appreciate you so much. I love
you, sweet sister. I love you too.
And I'm so thankful for you. And y'all need to try Bear's French Toast because it's so good. And y'all have a wonderful week. Don't forget to thank Jesus
and enjoy.
See you next time.
Bye.